hope that you will find this video a helpful complement to your course, and that watching our dancers' interpretations of the work will help in your approach to your own students. Grades 6 and 7 are primarily about the joy of dancing, as expressed through communication and performance. It is also hoped that students will relate their classwork to ballets seen in the theatre. Grade 6 is a bridge from Grade 5, preparing the foundation for Grade 7. The emphasis on expressiveness and performance is achieved through the use of the existing vocabulary in a more theatrical way. A logical choreographic flow links separate steps into amalgamations, enchaînements, and eventually into simple dance studies. We will begin Grade 6 by introducing the dancers. Amy, Jodie, Sylvie, Evelyn, Leah, and Sophie. Set to music by Glazunov, the plies should echo its singing quality and start the bar with poise and elegance. This is the first time steps have been combined, and as with all the combinations, we have designed them in such a way that they may be taught separately to start with. We hope that students will relate the accelerated ending to the coda, which often finishes a classical variation. Thank you. Batmo Frappe are now taken sideways to the bar, en croix to dégager, and with a brush à la seconde. We introduce a low ronde de jambe, en dehors only, and finish the setting with a port de bras, to encourage a feeling of movement and performance. We will now show you a close-up of the ronde de jambe. Note the height of the leg and the first ronde de jambe in even timing, followed by two ronde de jambe which have an emphasis on the extension. This adage is inspired by the ever-moving, flowing quality of the music. In the développé, there is no need for a high extension of the leg, but presentation in the upper body and musicality are paramount. Let's watch Amy and Evelyn. Now we have a change of mood with Sylvie dancing to a vivacious Spanish waltz.
Thank you.
Padbury PK are introduced in a setting with a demi-character feel, to finish the bar with style and confidence. Here is the ending once again, and you will notice how Jodie uses a strong epaulement to bring out the demi-character feeling. We begin with a choice of two port de bras, contrasted in mood, but both demanding a sensitivity of phrasing and expression. The first port de bras is inspired by the delicacy and subtlety of the music. It should breathe and flow and have a sense of calm and space. All the work in the lower grades on eye focus, sense of direction and communication can here be shown to full advantage. Let's watch Amy dance the solo version. With the duet version, there are two ways of interpreting the partner work, and we will show you both. First, Amy and Evelyn. The second version will be danced by Sophie and Leah.
Thank you.
This has a more romantic and sweeping quality, and the use of the upper body, as developed in the lower grades, is strongly featured. The central section has a change of mood, becoming more playful, before returning to the generous sweep of the opening theme. Here are two interpretations. First, Jodie. And now, Amy's interpretation. A gentle setting introduces temps lié in the centre. Thank you. the adage at the bar, a high extension on the développé is not necessary. Control and musicality is needed to echo the smooth and sustained quality in the music, and to bring out its poetic quality. This has a playful 9/8 time signature. First, here is Sylvie to dance the solo version. And now the continuous version. We introduce pas de bourrée en avant and en arrière and pas de bourrée piqué in a setting with a demi-character feeling, similar to the demi-point enchaînement at the bar. Here is Jody to show you the solo version. now Sophie and Leo will dance the duet version. When danced as a duet, the two dancers should have a feeling of communicating with each other and with the audience. Students may choose one of the classical, free movement or character dances to perform. If they choose the classical, it may be taken on either a 3-4 or 6-8 time signature. Let's see the 3-4 time signature first, danced by Leah. And now the 6-8 time signature. You will see how this gives the dance a lighter, more sparkling quality. First, we see Amy. And now, Sophie. Thank you. A traditional classical reverence completes this section. In the free movement, we have developed certain elements already established in the lower grades to suit the young teenager. The emphasis is on the use of back and torso, gravity and use of space. We hope, too, that the students will recognise these elements in the theatre when they see ballets in a more modern idiom or using a freer style. For this, a long length of silk is introduced to help develop a full and sensitive use of the upper back. To make the silk float in the right way demands a subtle strength and flexibility in the upper body and shoulders. The silks look beautiful as well, and they are fun to use. In this first exercise, the use of gravity is extended into a movement to the floor at the end, which has a feeling both of sinking into the floor, but also lifting away from it, a little like the two-way stretch of a plié. The time signature is a 9-8. Here we'll show you, more slowly, the two ways in which the changes of grip, from the short to the long side of the scarf, may be achieved. Firstly, taking the right-hand edge of the scarf. And now, taking the left-hand edge. Here is a joyous and exuberant jump, where we want the dancers to use every inch of space they have. Here is the solo version danced continuously. You will notice that, in their effort to stay in camera shot, several of the dancers have slightly mistimed the opening run. And now the duet version. You will see the dancers have reduced their travelling in order to stay within camera shot. We obviously wish them to travel as much as possible in the dance studio. Thank you. have introduced running with a feeling of spiralling in the back, and the whole dance should have weight and swing and generous use of the body. Character work in grade 6 and 7 is a natural progression from the lower grades. In grade 6 we continue the study of Polish court style, using steps already learnt in grade 5 and adding the polonaise and mazurka as dance forms to join the Krakowiak. We are anxious at this level that pupils and students will have a glimpse of what they are learning when they see the character dances of the traditional productions of Coppelia, Swan Lake and Sleeping Beauty. It is also hoped, by including some of these steps in the Royal Academy syllabus, we are preserving some of the heritage of our art form for future generations. We intend the character section to provide an opportunity to work with partners and to underline the sense of performance already established in the classical and free movement sections. The character work in the higher grades is presented in a more choreographed way, three enchaînements and a dance at each level, to give the students a feeling of stage performance throughout and at the same time an opportunity to learn and maintain the essential difference in style between Polish and Hungarian dance. The higher grades also add further important dimensions and areas of study for major students, and their value should not be underestimated. The Polonaise is an introductory dance, and as in all the character enchaînements, may be presented as a solo or a duet. When watching traditional productions of the classics, the students will see the Polonaise at the beginning of Act 3 of The Sleeping Beauty, and they may recognise the final step of the enchaînement when watching the mazurka in Act 3 of Swan Lake. We would like to emphasise the advantages of presenting all these enchaînements as duets. There is the obvious extra dimension added to the learning process of working with a partner. A sense of performance is enhanced in many cases where students are a little self-conscious dancing alone. It is often much easier to respond to a partner with the use of facial expression, thus adding to the overall performance. Here we show you the action of the feet once again. see the traditional Polish mazurka step in arabesque and the traditional pas marché. The object of these steps is to travel, and we must emphasise, therefore, that the duet shows only the pattern and not the best technique for the steps, as the dancers need to keep within camera shot. This enchaînement uses steps already learned in grade 5 and works equally well as a solo or as a duet. We feel it is important for the students to learn the Russian mazurka step, which is the one that is seen in traditional productions of Swan Lake and Coppelia, for example. It has been placed as a training exercise because it was felt that the subtle rhythm of this step is more difficult to achieve than the rhythm for the Polish mazurka step. We would urge teachers to use this enchaînement in class, as it is a vital educational link. It can be taken continuously as two solos or two duets. Thank you. The dance is based on Polish mazurka and other steps from the second enchaînement. It is in the musical form ABA, and the final section includes a short extract from the Swan Lake mazurka. The ending may have a single or a double pirouette. If two candidates in a group wish to show the character dance, it can be presented as a duet. Once again, the dancers have reduced their travelling to keep within camera shot.